afternoon. Distinguished industry leaders from IT and electronics fraternity, senior bureaucrats from state governments, friends from the media, ladies and gentlemen. When asked about the objective of this gathering, I simply had to put this forward. We are here to learn and learn to create benchmarks and not follow benchmarks. A warm welcome to all of you, and we are grateful for you to taking the time to be part of this IT conclave, and especially in spite of this COVID scare that we have around. Just to take a step backwards, and I'll explain to you how our Honorable CM has looked forward development in a different light altogether. One of the first things the Honorable CM has done is he brought around a convergence of the whole ministries around. Now today, right from our investments, infrastructure, industry, IT, commerce, right up to your skilling, it all heads under one ministry. So what used to be in three different ministries are today sitting in under one ministry, which basically means the ease of doing business is got that much more easier for all the investors coming to Andhra Pradesh. Through this IT conclave, we aim to deepen our relationships with the IT fraternity, brainstorm on various ideas that can help both the IT sector and the states march towards a mutually beneficial progress. We also promise to stay engaged with all the leaders here and convert the dialogue into action on the ground. This IT conclave attains even more significance given how the pandemic has compressed timelines for technological adoptions and digital transformation. In the past year, we have seen that technologies which probably would have taken 5 years to be adopted took no more than 5 months. Such a dynamic, changing world will also require a fast responding administration in order to align with the employment and innovation opportunities with the global needs. It is within this context that I hope that today's session will bring together some of the greatest minds in the IT industry and help the government formulate best policies to take the state forward. It is only under the dynamic leadership of our Honorable Chief Minister we see that this change is possible. Since the present government has taken over in May 2019, our belief has been in building a sustainable model, a sustainable society, and taking everyone along the path to progress needed fresh thinking and backing with of data. Our endeavor is to build on the same guidelines as advocated by World Economic Forum, that is the ESG model that has come out, that is environment, social, and governance. We have carefully orchestrated our actions on these guidelines. In order to do the same, we started looking at the fundamental building blocks of a society and benchmark our state with some of the other better performing states within India and also with leading countries globally whom we wanted to emulate. We performed rigorous analysis using data available with the government as well as assimilating feedback from our Honorable Chief Minister's Padyatra that he undertook on 341 days covering a kilometers of 3,648 kilometers. The seed of the action was then laid. The realization was very stark and strongly motivated us to form the bedrock of our governance. Just as Mr. Bill Gates had once remarked, humanity's greatest advances are not in the discoveries, but in how these discoveries are adopted to reduce the inequalities, whether through democracy, strong public education, quality healthcare, or broad economic opportunities. Reducing inequality is the highest human achievement. We resolve to ensure social justice in every scheme implemented by our government and created opportunities across the economic and social strata in the society. The state started to refocus on the multiple social indicators such as education, healthcare, agriculture, and availability of skilled manpower. We vowed to improve on several key performing indicators by not only allocating and spending money, but also leveraging technology wherever possible to increase the reach and utilize the funds efficiently. Our resolve to aim at solving the above challenges crystallized into several programs across all these sectors. For example, in our education sector, our health, I mean, education secretary was kind enough to explain what is the progress that they have done. But I'll also like to add over here that what Mahatma Gandhi, our great father of the nation, had once said, education should be so to revolutionize as to answer the wants of the poorest villager. Today, I'm very happy to say, under the dynamic leadership of our Honorable Chief Minister, the empowerment program in education especially, which is at the heart of our Chief Minister, is basically not only we are seeing the result, the fruits of this labor, but I can also tell you that the gross enrollment ratio across all the demographics has improved remarkably. While schemes such as Manabadi, Nadu, Nedu builds the school infrastructure schemes such as Jagananna Vidya Divana, Jagananna Vidya Kanuka takes care of not only school fees, but also stationery and reading materials for the students. Many a times I've been asked questions across the world, across the country. There is there's this paradigm question of saying, what's happening in your state? Where is the development? I can tell you all, the development that our leader has resolved is to start the movement from the villages. And I am very happy to say that he is reaching the poorest of the poorest, neediest of the neediest. And I can tell you these results that are going to be coming out will actually be seen for the rest of the country to be followed. Schemes such as Jagananna Goru Mudda ensures that these children are fed, while Jagananna Ammavadi encourages mothers to send children to school. In the healthcare, we renewed our strength and strengthened the YSR Arogyashree to ensure that good quality healthcare is available to all citizens who cannot afford the same. Additionally, to ensure financial support to patients who are in recovery post any hospitalization, we launched YSR Arogya Ashram to provide crucial support during the accidents, even in remotest parts of the state. The government also launched 1,088 new ambulances in order to reduce the emergency response into less than 15 minutes. Additionally, the government is establishing 16 new medical colleges to ensure enough high-quality doctors are available to serve the people of the state. Insurance schemes by the government have drastically revamped and restructured through the YSR Bima. And in terms of discussing my own ministry, this government, in the hardest of the hardest times during the COVID, we reached out to the MSME sector, which is the backbone of the industry, through YSR Navodayam for MSMEs. We helped them to restructure their loans, and not only restructure their loans, we had paid out the last 6 years of dues that was due to this MSME sector, totaling about 1,100 crores. Jagananna Todu is another scheme that helped the small-scale traders who are struggling with high interest rate, and YSR Sunna Vadi Patakam helped provide zero interest loans for women in self-help groups. Additionally, in agriculture and allied sectors, while agriculture sector employs majority of the people in the state of Andhra Pradesh, the sector needs tremendous support to ensure that the basis financial sustenance is provided to these families. While the YSR Raito Bharosa is to ensure support for investment during the sowing season, the government is also setting up 10 gigawatt of solar power to ensure daytime power to the farmers. A YSR Raito Bharosa Kendra has been established in every village secretariat to cater to all the needs of the farmers. From seed to sale, we are also establishing 147 YSR agri-testing labs at the constituency level and 13 labs at the district level to increase the agriculture production. In addition to the investment support and power, the government is also providing YSR free crop insurance. You all are aware what our welfare schemes have reached out to be. The government has extended almost close to about 5.65 crores beneficiaries with an assistance of 77,731 crores in the last financial year. How is the state leveraging technologies in such schemes, in the state schemes? I can just explain to you that while the state has lost multiple schemes to benefit the citizens directly, it is also trying to harness technology to come up with innovations to deliver service. One of these, we are seeing that the IT industry is rapidly changing the world across in every aspect of life. While we see the service sector changing rapidly with the help of the e-commerce firms, we are also seeing governments across the globe adopting technologies. And I can tell you, those governments which are adopting technologies or which are going to look forward into the technologies are those governments which are going to better the development of the governance sector. Multiple aspects of governance, from service delivery to welfare schemes and planning and executing capital projects, to data mining for identifying trends in the growth hubs across the states are seeing deployment of the latest technologies. Some of the digital initiatives to fight the COVID-19 that had taken place was home quarantine monitoring dashboard, CDAC SMS gateway for monitoring foreign returnees, availability of mandal-level video conferencing system. I mean, apart from this, what are we doing here in the state of Andhra Pradesh in creating the infrastructure, the IT infrastructure? The state of Andhra Pradesh has been extremely been proactive in attracting investments in this, especially in the IT infrastructure. My department is now actively engaged with multiple marquee IT companies for new projects in the state, as well as expansion of the existing operations. One of the such subject that which is being forward and which is being going to be discussed in one of the roundtables is the concept cities. Our Honorable Chief Minister believes that to develop the next level of living, the futuristic livings, he wanted us to take up three centers, minimum about 2,000 odd acres across the state, and then develop it into a concept cities. And today, I think one of the subjects that we'll be discussing and ask, probably looking out for answers from the diaspora, is that, you know, how can we make this concept city into a reality? The IT concept city is purposed to have SEZ and non-SEZ areas, connectivity to highways and airports, the plug-and-play units, the working spaces, the serene atmosphere, and also what we have also done is through the state fiber net, we are going to be creating the last mile connectivity. We will be providing broadband to every nook and corner of the state. The Honorable CM envisages internet connectivity to all the villages by 2024. We are also looking at integrated technology parks. To create the best working environment in a post-COVID-19 world, the government is proposing to establish an integrated technology park consisting of high-end skills university, incubation centers, center of excellence, labs, co-working spaces. The other one where we are looking at a digital transformation is at happening at the Gram Panchayat levels. We are working on creating the digital infrastructure up to the Gram Panchayat level, which includes high-speed internet connections to all the villages and establishing digital broadband, creating digital libraries with video conferencing facilities to all the village wards and secretaries. Additionally, these spaces will provide 5 to 6 workstations in every Gram Panchayat, totaling about 90,000 workstations to be provided in the next 2 to 3 years. The importance of this IT conclave, I cannot stress again. World over, the private industry works very closely with the government to ensure that the policies and regulations keep track with the demand of the industry. When such collaboration happens, the youth of the state or the country benefit tremendously. Today's IT conclave is an effort to bring the doyens of the IT industry to have deliberations with the government on various topics pertaining to the fields of the IT. The conclave will discuss various topics such as concept cities, skilling, IT and emerging technologies, startups, work from anywhere, and electronics manufacture. Each of the CXO roundtables will feature one of these topics and will aim to understand perspective from the industry leaders and multiple leaders from the IT industries, as well as senior bureaucrats who are part of the panels. All the discussions will be distilled, and the lessons learned will become part of the thought process during the future policy making. Before I conclude, I would like to also point out to you, while we dwell into the discussion of how the industry and the government can come together, it is my sincere request to all of you to provide your sincere opinion on the challenges that lay ahead for the state and the way which we can overcome the same. We also wish to partner with the IT leaders present here in bringing investments, creating jobs, deploying technology to solve the current issues and help drive the state towards a prosperous future. And before I conclude once again, I would like to thank my sincere appreciation to the Department of IT, led by our Secretary, Srimati Sri Jayalakshmi Garu, and Mr. Nandakishore, and our advisors, Srinath and Vidyasagar, and my dear YPOs, Sri. My special thanks to Sridhar Ramarao, Krishna, and Sri Maineni. Wish you all the best and a sincere success in the coming future. Thank you. Jai Hind.
ఈ వీడియో గనుక మీకు నచ్చినట్లయితే లైక్ చేయండి, షేర్ చేయండి. మరిన్ని వీడియోస్ కోసం మా ఛానల్ను సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేయండి.